believe it's an attack on the glory of our Lord. It's an attack on his holiness and who he is and his very nature. Because when you believe in millions of years, you've got death and disease and animals eating each other and horrible things, and there's fossil record over millions of years, and then God says that is very good. It's an attack on the atonement. Because then death is not the penalty for sin. It's always been here. You know, in the fossil record, there's evidence of animals eating each other, animals swallowing animals, bones in their stomachs. How could that all be millions of years before man when the Bible says originally all the animals were vegetarian? And so was man. Now, we weren't told we could eat meat until Genesis 9 after the flood, when God said, just as I gave you the plants, now I give you the animals. God changed our diet. You know why? Because sin changed everything. Millions of years has death and bloodshed in the fossil record, millions of years before man. The Bible says, by one man sin entered the world, and death by sin. It's not a matter of what you think God did. It's a matter of what God said he did. God took Adam's rib and made a woman. That evolution has man from an ape man, woman from an ape woman. The Bible has man from dust, woman from his side. Did God get it wrong? The issue before us is one of authority. Is this or is this not the absolute authority of the Word of God? That's really the issue. That's what the battle's all about. There are only two religions in the world. Did you know there's only two? That's it. There are only two. Go to Genesis chapter 3. Trust God or you become as gods. You trust God or trust man. That's it. They're the two religions. Secular scientists will say there was a big bang billions of years ago when we weren't there. Secular scientists say the world's millions of years old and they weren't there. But those same secular scientists will say man evolved from ape-like creatures. The secular scientists will say you can't have a virgin birth in humans. Secular scientists will say a man can't walk on water. The secular scientists say you can't have a man rise from the dead. The message of Jesus comes from this book, does it not? And if people's minds today, and young people's minds today, if that book has been undermined, if they have been caused to doubt that it's really trustworthy, then why will they listen when you talk about the message of Jesus from the same book? What I'm doing tonight, One Blood, One Race, my book, The Lie of Evolution, the importance of the book of Genesis, the death and suffering issue, how could a loving God... Oh, by the way, there are actually three answers books. You need to make sure you get the other two as well. You know what? You just need the best of everything. And by the way, we discount that 50%. That's the cream of the crop for teens and adults. For little kids, here's a little set of books. We've seen more kids come to know the Lord through those books and be equipped, ready for this world. It connects the Bible to the real world, even for little kids.